Brick by Brick Audiobooks presents Insurmountable Edge, a story in three books. Book 3 by Thomas H. Goodfellow. Read for you by Scott Brick. For J.A.G. What is a fair lifespan for a human being? And if that life be taken by another before its natural end, what debt shall be owed? Inscription on a stone tablet found on the island of Mykonos. Author unknown, circa 1200 BC, translated from the Greek. Part 5, The Valley, continued from Book 2. Chapter 93. Adelaide and I made a quick search of the bunker and identified where the air ducts came in. We then exited the bunker by squeezing between the side of the bunker's entrance door and the slinky-like air hoses. We headed up the bunker's outside stairs to the base of the crater. I carried the Enigma machine under my arm. "There's still one thing you forgot to ask me," Adelaide said. "I didn't forget," I said. "You didn't, huh?" Adelaide said. "What am I talking about, then?" "You realize the challenging tone of your question is just setting you up for embarrassment, don't you?" I said. "Now I'm sure you have no idea what I'm talking about," Adelaide said. "My mind is fine, Adelaide," I said. "I passed out down there. I didn't die." "I thought you said you were taking a nap," Adelaide said. "Nap? Pass out? No difference," I said. "Right," Adelaide said. "You'll forgive me if I think you're full of shit. However, because it's obvious you're stalling, as you still haven't asked me the one thing you forgot to ask me." "Okay," I said. "Just remember I tried to warn you. For the sake of argument, let's consider all workstations and desks as desks. How many desks were there in the bunker?"
"God damn it," Adelaide said.
"I got it right," I said. "That's what you thought I had forgotten to ask?" "Yeah, you got it right," Adelaide said. "I told you were just going to embarrass yourself," I said. "I included the vice president of Dark Programming's desk in my count and came up with 59 desks. Is that what you got?" "Yes," Adelaide said. "Freddy said the hazmat guys counted 56 dead, which is what I counted as well," I said.
"Me too," Adelaide said.
"Means three of the Dark Programmers weren't in the bunker when the carbon monoxide was pumped in," I said. "So if the blonde guy on the floor isn't Nemo, we have about a 1 in 19 chance Nemo is still alive," Adelaide said. "Assuming the explosion that created the crater didn't get him," I said.
"Forgot about that," Adelaide said.
"However, it's possible the odds actually might be better than 1 in 19, I said.
"They might?" Adelaide said.
"There's additional data to consider," I said. "For example..." I was interrupted by the ringing of my iPhone. It was Haley attempting a FaceTime call.
"Hold on, Adelaide," I said. "I want to take this."
"I want to hear about the additional data," Adelaide said. "Patience," I said. I stopped where Adelaide and I were, which was then about halfway up the bunker's outer staircase, and answered the phone. Adelaide gave me a dirty look and continued up the stairs on her own. Haley's face was on my iPhone screen. She didn't look any less beautiful than the last time we had spoken, despite the fact that she probably had been up for at least 48 hours. "Haley," I said into the phone, "aren't you afraid that if you keep hanging around NORAD, they might never let you leave?"
"They're treating me pretty nicely, actually," Haley said.
"They'd be fools not to," I said.
"Thank you," Haley said. "I'm afraid I've got some not-so-great news."
"You still haven't been able to find the second Doctors of Mercy plane?" I said.
"No," Haley said. "We found it. It's parked on an abandoned runway in the middle of the desert off Route 62, about 35 miles north of Blythe."
"They just left it there?" I said.
"Looks like they blew all the front landing gear tires when they touched down," Haley said. "Runway might have been in rougher shape than they thought."
"I assume you didn't find anyone on board," I said.
"The 30 mercenaries who landed in Oklahoma City have vanished into thin air," Haley said.
"Which is bad in and of itself. What's worse is there was also something else on the plane."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.